Have you ever tried to build a stroke that looks like this in Figma? With multiple levels on the same stroke, different widths, different colors, different styles. You might have thought that Figma just doesn't support it at all. And sure, you could duplicate and stack a shape on top of itself to get this effect, but then how would you do this? Not possible, you say. Well, we're going to do it right now, and I'm going to show you how to use this effect on any shape, including auto layout shapes that expand and contract based on their contents. It's a really cool trick, and I can't wait to show it to you, so let's do it right now. I won't keep you in suspense for too long. Here's exactly how it works. We have a component that defines what the shape is, and then we have some stacked instances of that component, and each of those instances we have overridden the stroke and fill, sort of like this. So this exact same component, I've pulled multiple instances and applied a styling to each layer. So really we are stacking objects on top of each other, it just so happens that they're instances of a component. Let's look at it here. If I edit my component, here is a stack of instances with different stylings. And as you might expect, as I change the shape of my one master shape component, all the layers will respond. And to achieve that little trick I did earlier, all I have to do is move this component directly on top of this stacked instance and then hide the stroke. I've actually got my component now stacked right on top of the instances, and I get this beautiful effect. It looks like I'm editing all the layers at the same time, which in a way I am. And you don't need to limit yourself to just one style using this stacked stroke approach. Here we have a master shape that's got three different stacked variants. And if we were to pull one of these out onto a page, maybe we have a couple copies of it, we can actually set which style variant the different instances have. Now that is super cool. And these are all still connected to the master shape over here. So if we were to go in and edit this shape, everything gets updated simultaneously across all styles and instances. Super neat. Now, if you've been using Figma for a while, you may already be thinking, hey, I've got an idea. What if I made this also a variant and I had multiple shapes? I could swap these in and out, maybe using something called instance swap. Unfortunately, for the moment, that does not work. Because whenever you do an instance swap, all the styling gets reset and you lose all of your beautiful work. So until Figma supports instance swap that maintains styling overrides like we've done here, we are stuck with one shape. Hopefully soon in the future we hear that Figma has added support, and then can you imagine you could have shape variants and style variants for every instance that you place. Fingers crossed that comes soon. But for now, one shape. Now, as interesting as this all is, you're more likely to use this trick on simple buttons and frames like we do in Figma every day. So let's talk about that. Now, what if we wanted to make a very simple button that had three levels of stroke on it? I'm going to start with a piece of text, put an auto frame around it. Let's add a stroke, a little bit of a radius, and a little bit of padding. Doesn't matter at this point, we're just playing. Let's imagine I want three levels of stroke on this button. I'm just going to, for the moment, make three copies of it. Bottom layer will be red, and we'll put a nice thick stroke on it. I'm going to make it centered. We'll take this next layer and make it a blue and a little bit thicker. And then finally, on top, we'll put a white stroke on top. I'll make that centered as well. Now, I'd like to just enter the text once and have all three of these buttons adjust to the right size. So I'm going to get rid of the text on two of them. Now this box is already set to hug, so it's working as expected. But these ones have nothing in them to hug, so what we can do is wrap the whole stack in another frame. We'll fill it with a little bit of gray so we can see it. And I'm going to put auto layout on this frame. So the red frame needs to be set to width hug, so it follows the width of the text. Let's try that. And we set the outer frame here to hug. What's interesting here is that this red frame now is hugging, the outer frame is hugging, and now these other layers are expanding to fill. So the width of the red frame determines the width of the outer frame, and then these ones fill to expand it. So hug is winning over fill in this case. It's kind of an interesting situation. So when you've got part of the content is set to hug, and part of it set to fill, hug wins in that competition. So it's an interesting trick. So I can get all of these three boxes to respond in width based on just the width of one piece of text, which is interesting. But now how do we get them stacked on top of each other? Well, we've got a gap, and most of the time in Figma, we're dealing with positive gaps, but this is one of those rare situations where we actually want a negative gap, and we can make them all the way on top of each other. Of course, we've got our order in the wrong order, but there's a new setting in Auto Layout here that determines which order the layers within a stack. Once you've highlighted the frame that's doing the auto layout, you click on these little switches and you've got a new choice here on Canvas stacking first on top. Now look at what we've got if I zoom in a little bit here. We've got our white stroke, our blue stroke, and our red stroke. And we've got a piece of text. Let me type something here. And you can see not only is it responsive, but it's honoring the stacking order. Everything's working beautifully. Let's get rid of the padding on this enclosing frame and don't clip content. So that outer frame is important because we need it to pull in to the hug frame, the red one, and then it also gives a place for the blue and white layers to fill. So it's a bit confusing, but you do need that outer frame. Now we can make a component of this, and I'm just gonna call it fancy button. Now imagine we've got a frame here, I'm gonna fill it with white, and we are using instances of our fancy button. And because there's only one layer of text and all the layers respond to it, we can change the name of the text box and we have all the layers working beautifully. Isn't that cool? So we've got an auto layout frame that supports multiple stroke thicknesses and is responsive to a single layer of text. So that's fantastic. Now, what if you wanted to support those multiple styles of stacked frames that we were talking about earlier? Well, that's just a matter of going back to this fancy button and creating a variant of it and just taking the effort to go to the stroke layers on each one and change them to different styles. I'll quickly do one here. All right, so here I've created one that's more of a roadway. I'll give this variant a name like road. And now when we go to our instances that have been placed, we can actually change the style here. Oh my God, that's so cool. So we not only support stacked strokes that are responsive, we can also change those styles with variants as well. Believe it or not, there's even more we could get into, but I think that's enough for one video. Isn't that amazing? And you thought that it wasn't possible. Well, now we know how to do it. Hope you find some use for that little hack. It's really neat. And the whole idea of being able to do multiple strokes stacked on top of each other, I was always frustrated that Figma didn't support that. And boy, with a little bit of practice, you'll be able to do this too. Okay, well, I hope you enjoyed that and good luck using this in your next project. Talk to you soon and be sure to subscribe.